If you want to move things with CSS, and especially if you want to animate them, it's best to use CSS Transform property. But there is one pretty big downside to using that property, and that is you have to define all the functions related to the CSS Transform in a single line in that single property. And that can be challenging or rather restrictive if you want to animate some of those properties separately. Maybe you want to first scale up the element and move it a little bit to the left. Maybe you want to rotate it afterwards. And you can't really do that when using CSS Transform. But there is a way around that if you use individual transform properties. In this video, I'll show you exactly how. All right, as always, I have a demo here on CodePen. You're gonna find the link in the description. And the first thing that I wanna show you is how transform actually works. Here we have a button with the class of link. Let's create a simple transform. When we translate that button on the axis of X and Y, 20 pixels in both directions. Transform, translate, we're gonna have 20 pixels, comma 20 pixels. And as you can see, this button has been translated. And if we want to add another function to that same transform, we would have to add it directly in that rule, in that property transform right here. So for the sake of readability, I'm gonna add it to a new line and let's do rotate 5 degrees. And you can see in our preview right here that this is working. Let's also add another property and scale this button up for maybe 10%. And there we go. We have our transformed element right here. But what if we wanna do this transform on hover? In that case, we would add hover here, link hover, and upon hover, this element would be transformed and all of those properties would be applied, would be translated, rotated, and scaled. Now, to actually animate it, we would add transition property to the link element, and we wanna add it to the link and not to the link hover element because we want to animate it both on hover in and hover out. So we will add transition, we will transition transform property over the course of 0.2 seconds, and we're gonna use ease transition timing function. So let's see how this works. When we hover it, our button is animated in and out. Now the challenge here is, what if we want to actually animate or transition those properties we have right here separately? Maybe we want to first translate the element, then rotate it, and then finally scale it up. We can't really do this because we only have this one property that we can transition. So alternatively, we could maybe use animations. We would define them with CSS keyframes, but in that case, we would have to repeat our entire transform with all of its properties for each step of the animation. And furthermore, we would not be able to easily get the animation back or animation out effect. So that is not really a viable option here. And alternatively, thankfully, what I want to show you in this video, you can actually use all of those functions as separate properties. So let's see how. Let's comment this out. If we want to apply translate property, we just copy this. And the only difference between the translate property and the translate in the transform function is that you don't use commas between those X and Y coordinates. So let's remove those. And if we hover our link now, you're going to see that it's actually translated. So this is essentially the equivalent for our translate function. And if we want to animate it or transition it, we can add it right here. We're gonna transition our translate property over the course of 0.2 seconds with the ease animation timing function. And sure enough, it works. Just as well, we can now add our rotate function and it's gonna work exactly the same as translate. You just type in a rotate with the 5 degrees. And if we test our button now, it's going to be immediately rotated because we haven't added the rotate to our transition function. If we wanted to animate it at the same time, we could just write transition all, and this would transition all properties over the course of 0.2 seconds, as you can see right here. But if we want to animate those properties separately or transition those properties separately, we can do that if we define another transition in the exactly the same property. In this case, we're just gonna do rotate, again 0.2 seconds, but we're gonna add 0.2 second delay to that transition. So what's gonna happen here is we're gonna translate our element over the course of 0.2 seconds by 20 pixels on the X and Y axis, and then we're gonna rotate that element over the course of 0.2 seconds. Let's see how it works. And as you can see, we now translate the element, then rotate it, and when we hover out, the same transition will be applied in the reverse order. And this will be very complicated to do with CSS animations or CSS keyframes. And just as well, we can use the scale property here. And we're gonna add another line here, which is going to say scale over the course of 0.2 second with the ease animation timing function. And we're gonna delay that animation by 0.4 seconds because we wanted this one to finish and this one to finish. Only then we want to initialize our scale transition. So our entire animation, or rather transition, will be 0.6 seconds. Let's demonstrate how it works. And exactly as you would expect, we translate the element, rotate the element, and then we zoom it in or scale it up. And that is exactly the advantage of using the individual properties instead of transform with its functions. In addition, this block of code is also, I think, more readable than this one, because this one is all in a single property. Often people format it in a single line, which is not really ideal. And another thing I want to mention is that translate, rotate, and scale properties take in multiple values. Translate can be defined with one value, two, or three values. If it's defined with the one value, the element is going to be translated on the x-axis, second value is y-axis, and the third value is z-axis, or rather how deep or how close to us that element gets. So it's also translated by 100 pixels on the z-axis. And you don't see any difference because for the z-axis to work, we also need to define perspective. And we would define perspective on the parent element of our link. And the parent element, if we look at the HTML, is going to be content. And just for the example, let's do perspective 400 pixels. And now if we hover over our button, you're going to see that we applied z of 0 pixels to our translate property right here, which means that the element is going to be scaled down. But that's not really the point. I just want to show you how translate property works. Rotate property can take multiple arguments as well. If you define it with a single value, like right here, it's gonna be rotated around the Z axis, but you can also specify over which axis you actually want to rotate that. And you would do that by saying we wanna rotate it on the X axis by 5 degrees. And to make this a little bit more apparent, I'm gonna increase rotation to 15 degrees. So you can see right here what we have. And you could also do Y axis, in which case you're gonna rotate it on the Y axis by 15 degrees. And rotate can also be used as a rotate 3D function, in which case you would define it with the three values plus an angle. The numbers here will represent exactly as in rotate 3D, the origin of the vector, and the degrees will be basically the rotation of that element over the vector we defined. And lastly, we have our scale property right here. And scale property also takes multiple values. And when you use a single value element, it's gonna be scaled on the X and Y axis. But if you use multiple values, you're gonna be able to scale it separately on the X and Y axis. Let's try this. So we're gonna scale it on the X axis by 1.1, and we're gonna scale it by the Y axis by 1.5. So our element appears stretched out because we scaled it more on the y-axis than we did on the x-axis. And if we add a third value, this is going to effectively represent a scale 3D function from our transform property. And the scaling transformation will be characterized by the 3D vector that is defined with those three values. And what is the browser support for those individual properties? Well, browser support, it's not really there. Currently, this is supported in Firefox and Safari, but it's not supported in Chrome. So all of this means that you're gonna have to use feature detection if you wanna use those individual properties. And you can do this fairly easily, like I've shown in one of my previous videos, how to use supports at rule. So if you would want to detect the browser support for the scale property, for example, you would write it something like this. Let's remove this first. And let's wrap all of this code that we've used here into supports at rule. And we're gonna detect if the browser supports scale property with the value of 1.1. And if it does, we're gonna apply all of that code right here. And now if you test this demo in a browser that doesn't support individual properties or specifically scale property that we tested right here, this block of code will not be applied at all. And with all this newfound knowledge, we can actually create quite a bit interesting effects with our individual transform properties. So let's create a simple one, a little bit more interesting than this one. I'm gonna comment this code out. So first, what I wanna do is I wanna scale up the element, and I'm gonna scale it up by 20%. So we can also add this to our transition property right here. And I also wanna rotate the element. And I'm gonna use the rotate 3D to rotate it over a vector to make it a bit more interesting. Let's see right here. All right, this looks pretty nice and interesting. So now what we are doing here with the transition is we're scaling up the element by 20%, and then we are rotating it with the 0.2 second of delay on this particular vector that we defined right here on a 15 degrees angle. And lastly, what I wanna do here is I wanna add also the active state. And for our active state, we probably want to scale down the element again to make it seem like it's being pressed. And also we want to reduce rotation a little bit right here as well. And let me also reduce the scale here. All right, and now if I hover over the element, it's gonna have this beautiful animation, or rather transition, where it's first scaled up and then rotated on this beautiful little vector here. There we go. And if I press the button now, our element is again gonna be first scaled, which means it's gonna be scaled down, and it's gonna be again rotated with a 0.2 seconds of delay. Let's see how. So it's scaled down and then rotated out. But for this case, I think we probably want to reverse our transition. So first we want to rotate the element out and then scale it down. So let's apply our transition here as well. We're just going to switch scale and rotate here. And now if I click the link, it's going to be first rotated out and then scale down. Or maybe we want to make this a little bit smoother. So let's reduce the delay by 0.1 second. So the scaled transitions happens before our rotate animation finishes entirely. And that looks pretty interesting. And whenever you're creating an interesting and experimental effect like this one, make sure that the button remains and is accessible. So I'm gonna test our focus styles by pressing the tab key, which are gonna be default browser styles, but I think it's gonna work fine. Let's see. And yeah, I think this is pretty okay. The button is focused and has a clear outline. So we have this beautiful little effect where we animate the button in. So on hover out, we use this transition again. We first scale it down and then rotate it out. And on click, we actually do the reverse. We first rotate it out and then we scale it down. I hope you found this interesting. I hope this helps you create interesting effects that would otherwise be impossible or very difficult to create without using the individual properties. Thank you so much for your attention. My name is Zoran Nyambor. I will see and hear you in the next video. Rotated by 20 degrees. I'm not gonna be actually rotated by 20 degrees. That would look really weird.